This happens to be from a neighbor who I never met, who lives a few miles from me, Gina, who's an amazing producer and director, content in her own right. And she told me Shawn's story about what, and you can see Shawn on there under Wonder Woman, about this amazing endeavor she was gonna do. And, you know, I've been waiting for quite some time to get Shawn on the horn with us so I can say, girl, are you crazy? So Shawn, why don't you give us a quick overview of what did you do? What did you wake up at 3 a.m. and go, I've got an idea. And next thing you know, in 6 weeks, you're going to be cycling across America. How did this happen?
Well, I lost my vision and I kind of had to redefine myself. I had to make a decision to choose to be someone I could be proud of. It was such a hard transition for me to go from a sighted individual, you know, working as a paramedic at the time, to a total blind person living that type of a life. And I didn't handle it very well in the beginning. And I think that if anything, I was starting to feel embarrassed as to my behavior and my attitude, essentially. So I feel like taking challenges helps me to keep the sadness from the loss in check.
Wow, that's amazing. Mm-hmm. And Gina, what kind of drew you to this to say, wow, this has to be a movie, the whole world has to see this? What was your thinking?
Well, I first met Shawn actually in 2015 when I was working on a project for ESPN about female veterans, because Shawn also is an Army veteran, and how sports has influenced their life post-service. And at the time, Shawn was just recently blind, right, Shawn, like three or four years. Mm-hmm. And she was, at the time, defying all expectations of trying to qualify for the Rio Games in paracycling. So I knew when I met her then that she was an extraordinary woman, extraordinary athlete, and just a person. And she also, at the time, I was a recent mother, I became a mother, and she was a single mother, and she was a single mother of two young children when she lost her vision completely. So on that level, I just thought I connected with her, and also that she was not only doing this extraordinary athletic accomplishment, qualifying under 3 years of learning how to cycle, essentially, to go to the Paralympics. She also had an amazing story of her as a woman and her abuse and trauma that she suffered even pre-injury. And so I just wanted to tell her story. And in 2018, she broke the record of the fastest rim-to-rim crossing of the Grand Canyon for any blind person, male or female. And so when I heard that, I called her and I said, hey, Shawn, I'm like, has anybody approached you to tell your story? And she's like, you know what? No, I want to. I have a lot to share and I have, you know, a lot more to do. And so since then, we've been working together. And I guess this past fall, she told me, she's like, hey, you know what? I'm going to ride across the country on a single bike. So she is a national champion on a tandem bike. And so she wants to be the first ever blind person to attempt this 3,900 miles from coast to coast. So when I heard that, I said, you know what, this is an amazing narrative arc for the film to tell your story. And then not only will it just be a wonderful quest to see what happens and all the tales and characters you see in between, but also telling her story in a more emotional and psychological way through sound design and animation to really kind of bring people into her world and how she's breaking barriers to live a very independent and empowered life. And so that's kind of where we are now.
Amazing. And Shawn, from your perspective, I mean, I'm sure if someone asked you to list the challenges on an endeavor such of this, it would basically be an encyclopedia. But is there any one challenge at the top of your list that most concerns you about this amazing endeavor?
I think the hardest aspect of trying to ride a single bike as a total blind person is the mental focus that it will take for me every second of every pedal stroke of movement on that bike across the country. Like I will not be afforded the luxury to let my mind wander, because the minute I do that, I'm guaranteed to have an accident, because I have to use everything to pay attention to keep myself safe.
Got it. And do you feel, I mean, it's now 7-8 weeks away, I can't do the math there, like, is everything, mm-hmm. and like, what kind of team is going with you? What kind of support team? What does that look like?
So right now I will have, there will be 7 of us on the road at all the time, at all times. I have 2 Army veterans that are, one is the driver of our RV and one is driving the follow car that will stay with the cyclist at all time. Times we have my son and a woman that we hired to kind of be like boss lady, and they'll have like a schedule and laundry runs, making sure we have groceries, getting the RV to the RV parks to get it connected at the end of the day. I'm hoping to connect with 4 schools for the blind and visually impaired on this route. So, you know, if something comes up where we're going to connect with people along the way, Mary and Riker will keep us on schedule. And then there's the 3 cyclists on the road. And hopefully we'll see Gina out there a couple of times. And I've got a couple of friends that will come out and give Jesse, my best friend Jesse, who's my primary guide out there, some relief in guiding me, because it's not only hard for me, it's also hard, very challenging for my guide.
Yeah, I mean, I can't even imagine. We have a 20-mile flat bike trail from my house, and there's like a tough hill. Now every time I come to the hill, I think of you, and the hill's not tough anymore. All of a sudden, nothing's tough anymore after hearing your story, to be totally honest. And Gina, how do you envision the movie from the perspective? Is this a movie of personal triumph? Is this a movie of an amazing athlete? Is this a movie about a trek across America and all the amazing places she'll go, or all of it combined? How do you see it?
Yeah, I think it's a combination of everything you just mentioned. Obviously I think it will be a quest. Story, you know, from beginning to end, like, can she do this, and all the unexpected things that will happen, you know, from state to state, and people that she'll meet. I think it's also going to be a character portrait of Shawn, and how she uses these challenges and sports to kind of defeat the struggle that she has every day when she wakes up, to kind of confront her sadness and tragedy. I think also it's more of a psychological portrait to see how she has used her post-injury therapy, because what she had was a traumatic brain injury. So she suffered a lot of trauma, and through a lot of these trauma therapy, she's kind of discovered even what her life was like pre-injury, and how she's used that to really empower her and to live this independent life. I think it's also a story, though, about breaking barriers and about self-belief. I think one of the reasons why Shawn wants to do this is to lead by example, you know, to really walk the walk. And so for somebody else to say, hey, you know what, if she can do this, like, what, maybe I can do this. So I think no matter what, you don't have to be disabled, you don't have to be blind or whatever. It's more about having people confront their fears and pushing themselves to see what's possible. So I think it really has multi-layers that we want to come across in the film. And I think for me, and I think for Shawn too, I want to tell it in her point of view. So that's why we will play a lot with like animation of how she's seeing this. How does she go through the world as a blind woman and sound design?
Great. So just so everyone knows, you don't know Gina. Gina is a photographer and commercial director for a living. That's her day job. And most of you know me that I produce brand-funded films as my day job. This is just something, a passion. Obviously, once Gina met Shawn, she was committed. And then once I spoke to Gina, I was committed. We're doing this. We just want to get it done. No one's, it'd be nice if I could buy a brand storytelling leather jacket after this. But honestly, we're doing this just to make a great movie and tell the story as opposed to our, you know, day jobs per se. So, you know, the idea did come up that the trip itself is being funded, meaning getting her from point A to point B to Z, but the movie is not. So we're now in discussions with a number of brands that make sense organically. They can be integrated into the storyline, as you can imagine, all the equipment and the clothing and hotels and RVs and everything that goes across a cross-country track. We're looking for brands to come on board to help tell the story with us, to be an outlet for us, to provide content for the brands, again, organically integrate them into the story, and to help us with the funding. So we've already had some great, very serious conversations, but we wanted to bring it to the brand storytelling team, because this is, no one makes connections better than Mike and Rick, who would be the right people. And it's great that we can come together. Look, it's great that we make a living on the professional side, but to tell a story like this is a once in a lifetime opportunity, in my view. So we're just looking to see who wants to come along with us on this ride. If you have any interest, or you go, oh my God, you should be in touch with XXX, please just message me, email me. I'm just Marcus at Passion Point Collective. But Rick and Mike have all our information. And you know, we'd love to have you come along the ride. Does anyone have any questions for Shawn or Gina that you want to either raise your hand or put in the chat box?
Marcus, I have a question to ask of this about the directing of the film. Is Gina, are you producing, directing? What's exactly your role?
Yeah, so I'm directing and also producing. We will have a production team, and we're in talks with a few production companies to help us see this film through. But my primary role will be the director, as well as probably some camera work as well on the road.
And do you have any brands that are signed on at this point? Is there any that are committed to the project?
We have one kind of a vitamin health supplement that we all know, and we're down to, you know, final terms, but you know, no ink yet. But then we have two others that are right behind. So no ink yet, but we're moving quickly, and we're excited to see who else wants to raise their hand and chat.
How about, you know, the potential prospects categories? I'm thinking, you know, are you staying in an RV along the way? I think Airstream.
Yeah, they have one already. They bought the RV before I could call Airstream. Oh, this is a great one.
RV is already on board, huh? Okay.
Hotels we're talking to, all our friends in the hospitality industry. Obviously, sunscreen we're talking to. There's so many organic, Shawn gave us a huge list, which was amazing, of everything that she naturally uses, but there's so much, you know, insurance companies, obviously, be good to have some insurance on this amazing adventure. So there's so many ways to integrate brands, honestly. So we're all ears on that front. And I see a chat.
Hey, Marcus.
Brand
that
USA.
Was my question. Zach, that was my question too. Hi, Marcus.
Yeah. Hey, Michelle. Brand USA is a great idea for sure. They're good brand storytelling friends, so that makes all the sense in the world. And for distribution, we're gonna, you know, shop around. We're talking to all of our friends at Apple TV and Google Play and Amazon, and everyone wants to see some footage. So, you know, a little early for that, but we'll have footage probably starting the beginning of May to share with to share with people. And we just spoke to some friends we just met at the Weather Channel. And they were like, gee, can we be part of this in Eretz? So we're going to have some nice options there.
How long does the trip take, do you expect, Shawn? How long do you think it's going to take you to do this?
So we're going to leave the morning of the 17th. We're hoping to average 80 to 100 miles a day. And we estimate around July 10th, but we're kind of trying to keep that a little bit flexible just for unexpecteds. And maybe we'll go faster. I don't know.
Where do you depart and arrive at?
We leave out of Florence, Oregon, and we will be finishing in Virginia Beach, Virginia.
Wow. So because of that, I mean, there's some of us on this Zoom that like to ride bikes. Mm-hmm. You know, this seems like an event. Would you invite people along the way to say, hey, I'm going to be in Topeka on this date. Come ride mm-hmm. day with me. You have a whole parade of people following you.
I mean, that I'm hopeful for connection along the way. I think that is what's going to really drive the energy behind this. You know, one of my hopes is that we have these helmets with Bluetooth two-way radio capabilities. So when people do come out with us, we can give people these helmets. We'll have the ability to not only ride with us, but talk to me at the same time.
Wow.
Because I'm a multitasker out there, but that way I have at least have the ability to connect with people. But yes, and we'll have a GPS. I have a Garmin Mini where we'll send the link out and people will be able to see our whereabouts every 2 minutes, or even send us text messages along the way that will go to Jesse's Garmin so he could even read to me as we're riding people that are watching us move across the country.
So the whole social aspect of this, of the whole trip, that people could follow you along the way, seems like a really great opportunity to build interest in the mm-hmm. final film and be a part of your trip.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
I got all kinds of thoughts about this and people that we need to talk to, Shawn. You know, first of all, thank you for coming on. What an inspirational person you mm-hmm. are. And to come on and talk to us is terrific. Anybody else in the chat want to chime in here? Any other questions?
I was just curious about the social. I was just going to bring that up as you guys got into it, but wondering what the plans were around that and how to activate local communities or, you know, riding clubs or schools, you know, where the kids would be able to follow along. It is such an inspirational story that, you know, I'm sure a lot of people would love to participate and, you know, everything from imagery to videos to, you know, building a community as you, it's a lot of time that you'll be on the road. So I think, mm-hmm. you know, it could snowball and I don't know, you could get like Facebook as a partner or something like that. I think, I don't know, I'd love to hear more about what your thoughts are there.
Gina, I was just going to say, if you're asking me, I am the worst. At this, and I don't feel like I have an appropriate, I'm overwhelmed by the thought of social media. But I also want to just say that this is about human connection. It's not about being interviewed by TV stations. That's not what that's not my interest in this. And so connecting with communities along the way is absolutely like that's where the energy is.
Yeah. And I think that someone on Shawn's team is getting the word out on like a local level for the towns and with military, first responder organizations, School of the Blinds, saying, you know, they're coming through your town. So I think there is someone who's like spreading the word. I think eventually we will have a PR person working the ride as well. We just have to be strategic with it. I think also just to preserve the authenticity of the ride, and also for Shawn's like mental health through it. We don't want to make it too much, like every place she goes that she has to be on constantly. But the social media aspect is something that we definitely want to explore more. If the brands that we are talking to, they'll also want some social media as well throughout the Transamerica journey. But I definitely think that there's a lot to explore of how we can kind of build Shawn, who I think this is very much like a launching pad for Shawn's own brand, really, of who she is and her introduction to the world. Because she has a lot more adventures she wants to do. To shatter some limitations. I think so.
Just terrific. And look, you've already recruited this army of people here to support you, Shawn. There's a lot of great minds on this Zoom right now. And I'm sure that we're all gonna go away and think of people that we wanna connect you with. So, you know, bravo to you for doing this. I'm anxious to see the film. I'd love to be at one of those stops along the way on my bicycle and try to keep up with you.
Thank you.